than 5 million Americans have orthodontic treatment every year, and one in five of those are adults. So before you spend big bucks on braces, you should know that new research has found that the orthodontic treatment you or your child gets now can determine how young you'll look in your 20s, 40s, and even beyond. Dr. Christine Dumas is here to reveal some amazing new technology. Hi, how are you? Nice
I'm
to
great.
See you, Christine.
Good to see you too.
So the technology of orthodontics, right, mm-hmm. has changed dramatically. Why is that?
Right now, before an orthodontist looks at your 11 or your 12-year-old, they should be able to take that her aging process into account and what she's going to look like when she's 50.
Well, how do they determine that, Christine, though? Isn't that hard to say because people develop at different rates and in different ways?
Thanks really to some award-winning work by Dr. David Sarver and Mark Ackerman, you can actually factor that aging process into the equation in a way that orthodontists never have been able to before. And so really now parents have to start thinking about the orthodontist as being the first person who's going to make a determination on how your child is going to age, well or not well, you know, into their 40s, 50s and beyond.
I know you have some examples, so show us what happens as we age in terms of our teeth and our jaw and our mouths, etc.
Okay, first thing is you have to take into account that as we get older, our lips are going to change. And so over time, if you think about it, when you're 20...
Well, mine have already changed. They're disappearing. But that's a whole different segment, isn't it?
No, they're not. But when you're 20, your lips almost look like a diamond, right? So mm-hmm. they look, it's almost like a Cupid's bow. And as we get older, it becomes more linear. So all the collagen in the world is going to factor in. It's trying to create the lips of a 13-year-old or a 20-year-old. So that's one of the big things as we start to look at some of these cases. You kind of have to see where the lips are relative to where the teeth are going to be to see what the child is going to look like.
So they're taking facial measurements, is that right?
See, before they would look at the skull and the jaw, and imagine if you went to a plastic surgeon and they just said, well, I'm going to look at a picture of your skull and then I'll figure it out. You have to look at the face and you have to measure the face. So we're going to take a look at some cases where we measure the face and see some dramatic results.
Okay, so why don't you take us through, this is, I guess, an example of somebody who was measured, and why don't you explain what the orthodontist does. This little girl,
you look at her smile, her name is Blair, not showing a lot of tooth, you can see already. So when she's 50, if she's not showing a lot of tooth now when she smiles, it's going to be not so good at 50. So let's watch how she changes. Puts the braces on, they're actually going to bring
her... Oh, that is so cool.
Isn't it cool? So they bring her teeth down, so look at now how more beautiful her smile is, but she's showing more tooth. So as her lip starts to come down, as she turns 40, 50, and 60, she's going to look younger longer.
Wow. Then we have Emily Putnam, right?
Emily Putnam.
Show us her case.
Let's look at this case. It's really interesting. Emily, when you look at her as 12 years old, has short teeth and has a gummy smile.
Uh-huh.
So what might have happened before
is I have that gummy smile too,
but only no you don't.
Yeah, I do. It's okay.
But you have but you know what? There's a difference between an emotional smile when you do that, but when you smile, it's perfect.
That's because I've learned how to compensate. But anyway,
so if we look at Emily's smile, what she does is an orthodontist might have thought.
Can we show that again?
We need to look at her before.
Okay, he's trying. I think we're having some technical problems. Okay, there.
So
you
if
go.
We look at her very gummy, an orthodontist might have said, you know what? I'm going to move those teeth up. She had short teeth. I'm going to move them up so she has a less gummy smile.
Is that hard to do, though, move teeth up?
They can do it up, down. But watch this. Watch as she grows. Leave the teeth alone and look at what she's... It's perfect.
That is so freaky.
It's perfect.
This is how they believe she'll look.
No, this is how she looks. This is how she looks. Dr. Sarver took her from age 8 to 28. That's the whole thing. The researchers said this is actually what happened. These are not imaginary things. This is her.
Oh, okay, because I thought they were predicting what they would look like in the future.
No, this is real. This is real
her
time.
Her hair color changed quite a bit.
It did. and the doctors had nothing to do with that. Okay, let's look at the next case.
Okay.
The other thing that happens as we get older, broader is better when you're looking at a smile. All right, so let's think about Julia Roberts.
It is. Why is it always better?
You know, it's going to support your facial structure better. Broad is really good.
Then so I'm in good
You're very good. I know. I'm like, broad. So let's look at Kim Busby. This young lady had a very narrow, restricted jaw.
But I think we have Julia Roberts first, don't we? Okay, we'll go to Kim. All right.
Kim's there. You might look at that and say she's got a whole lot of teeth there. What are we going to do with all those teeth, right? Take some out? Absolutely not. What they did, and we can watch as it moves now, they expand her arch and fill in that face, and Kim went to being a model. You look at that smile. Didn't take out any teeth, just expanded her upper arch. She's going to have great lip support as she gets older.
Now obviously, some of these teeth have been whitened as well. Is whitening kind of a necessary finishing touch in your view?
You know what, when we were younger, they'd finish, the teeth would be straight, and you'd walk out, your parents would see you, they'd be yellow. I mean, the expectation is, at the end of the case, we want the teeth to be white. So we have a case of a before and after.
Yeah, let's take a look at the before and after whitening shot, Joe, if we have that.
And in this particular, if you look at it, it's so much easier now. This is at the end of the case, 4 weeks after. They just used white strips on this case, and it's actually, you know, it went from yellow to white, which I think is what, you know, you want to see at the end result of white teeth.
Yeah, the technology has changed so much with whitening. Now they can do, there's the white. I was going to say, I haven't noticed much of a change. But now they can do laser things where they, but I worry about how your teeth can handle all these whitening agents, and they're completely safe.
Completely safe. I mean, what we're looking at here is we're looking at just one treatment after the braces come off. Lots of stuff comes up under the braces. I think the most amazing thing that what this research has shown, though, is what happens with extractions. Before you have an orthodontist extract even one tooth on your child.
We have Miss Alabama.
Miss Alabama.
Okay, can we see that, Joe? Miss Alabama? We don't have her, but go ahead and explain.
If we look at, we have two cases. One, you don't want to take out, if you leave too many teeth in, the mouth is going to look too full. That we have another really important case where you don't want to take teeth out, and that's a Hillary Stein is the name of the patient we're looking at here. You don't want to take teeth out because you can flatten a person's profile so that they're going to look really, really old at a very young age. So you can actually expand that out where you take her teeth and you turn the scroll, you can actually make her face longer and make her look amazing.
In closing, how can you make sure you go to an orthodontist who keeps all these things in mind as he fits you for braces or your children?
I think it's really important to ask the orthodontist what's going to happen in terms of your treatment plan at the end of 30 years. How is my child going to look, and what precautions are you going to take, bringing up the things that we talked about this morning.
To make sure that she grows into her teeth.
And looks young. She looks just as beautiful when she's 20 in her face as when she's 40.
All right, Christine Dumas. Thanks, Christine, so much. And up next, you...